Cartoons made during World War II are very hit and miss. The hits are usually very funny and combine classic cartoony humor with good old American morale boosting. And the misses usually forget about being funny and force too many stereotypes on the viewer and leave them with a bad taste in their mouth. Meatless Fly Day, though only very loosely related to the war, I believe, is a hit. I wish more war-related cartoons were made like this one. There's enough stuff in the cartoon that relates to current times to make the audience laugh, but at the same time, it's a classic two-character Warner cartoon that contains the usual classic Fritz Freleng timing, Mike Maltese story, and excellent Carl Stalling music. People seem to often forget the Warner one-shots, but some of them have really interesting and fun characters in them, as this one does. I also have to say that Carl Stalling is totally killing it with the soundtrack here. Stalling had just gotten the rights to the Raymond Scott music that he loved so much, and multiple of Scott's songs are heard throughout the cartoon, most notably Huckleberry Duck as the Spider's main theme song, and a lot of very obscure and weird songs that were used very scarcely by Stalling for the rest of his life, if ever again, like Siberian Sleigh Ride. Holly Pratt, though wasn't in the Frizz unit as a layout artist yet, came in around 1944 to be Frizz animator Dick Bickenback's assistant. I'm not so sure if Holly would have worked on this cartoon and would have assisted Dick here, but the Bickenback animation in this one is stellar regardless. Here's a very fun scene by Dick with good timing, good character work, and excellent but very subtle strokes of dry brush.
Goodies the big bad spider left for him.
Thanks as always for watching, gang. Keep on coming, and we'll keep on bringing you 7 commentaries a week, 2 freeze-framing videos a week, and 110% of our effort. Until next time.